What is happening, guys? Mike here, welcome back to the channel. So, I'm pretty glad you're here today. Why? Because today we are taking a look at a brand that personally I've wanted to take a look at for quite some time now. We got a lot of cool stuff planned for this video. I'm hoping that it's gonna be as fun for you to watch as it was for me to make, but time will tell. Who knows? Let's get started. All right, so today we are taking a look at the new matte clay from the Mailroom Barber. This is a brand that I've heard so many good things about, and I'm really glad to finally get a look at something from their line. Now, just looking at this one clay doesn't exactly give us a full look at this line and the brand behind it. So I'm hoping that very soon I'll get a chance to look at the other things that this brand has been putting out. But today we are taking a look at their new matte clay that I believe was released back in December. Now, you guys know I love me a good clay, so this is gonna be a lot of fun to review. We got to start now by getting a closer look at the product and some specs. Here we go.
Coming across my desk today is my first product from the humanitarian brand known as the Mailroom Barber. One thing that I love about homebrewers is their dedication, and after reading and researching this brand, I can tell they have 110% of this and more going into their products. According to the brand, the new matte clay pomade is the most versatile pomade in your arsenal. This is a petro-free oil-based clay that still washes out in one wash. It's also designed for dry, matte finished looks with lots of volume and texture. Scent-wise, we're working with a woodsy and floral evergreen scent with hints of jasmine. This product comes in a 4-ounce glass jar and is priced at $24. Looking inside the jar, we're met with a thick but creamy looking product. Scooping it out of the jar is not super hard, but it's definitely thick. It's not so thick that you have to use the back of your thumb, but it's definitely a thick scooper for sure. Once it's in the palm though, you can really feel that smooth consistency and texture come out as you break it down. Time to see how it styles. As usual, I'm gonna use the clay today on clean, dry hair. For those that like to ask, I washed my hair to prep for this demo using the suds shampoo from the salon guy. Hopefully sharing that info isn't too awkward and disingenuous for you guys. The rule of thumb with this clay that is both recommended by the brand and myself through my own testing is less is more. You want to start out with small amounts and add them in one at a time until you get the result you want. Here we're going to do 2 scoops, but I'm going to show you some additional options here in a minute. Adding it into dry hair here is very easy. It applies very smooth with no tug or pull at all. Styling here is pretty nice and easy. It's smooth enough to use a comb or a brush, but it actually responds really well to some good finger combing. In the end, achieving a good final style does not take much effort at all.
Now, during that demo, we used 2 scoops, but I thought it was important to show the versatility of this product because that's really what sets this clay apart from others, in my opinion. Really, the slightest difference in how you use this clay can produce a different result. So there we used 2 scoops, but here's a look at my final result with using only 1 scoop. Basically, what I see and feel here is more of a dry, matte finish and texture, where with the 2 scoops, I felt we just got a little bit further away from that. But in exchange, there we get a little more hold and still some good texture and volume. After repeatedly testing out this clay, one of the things I kept wondering about was the hold and how it could be improved. Usually in this situation, what I would do is just use more product, but as we saw in the demo, the more product you use, the further away from that matte finish we get. And I think we also lose a little bit of that potential for volume and texture. I mean, we don't really lose a ton because they did a great job of making sure it still has that dryness to it, but I could see a small amount of shine starting to set in right at the beginning with the more I used. Now, because of this, I started wondering how pre-styling would work with this clay. Not actually using this clay as a pre-styler, I don't really think that would work well at all. I meant just using a normal good pre-styler and then using this, of course, as a post-styler. So of course I wanted to test this out. I decided to use a pre-styler that I thought most of you would have, Original by Blumaan Styling Meraki. Now, this isn't a product placement or anything like that. I genuinely just thought thought it would be one the majority of you would already have since it's widely used in this capacity. It's also one of the ones that I use most often as a pre-styler. Here's a look at my end result after this test. I didn't notice a huge difference here, to be honest with you. I think the clay really takes over a lot and overpowers the texture and hold the original put in the hair to begin with, but I do think it does make a difference in the endurance later in the day. Now, speaking of that endurance, let's go back to our original test, the two scoops on dry hair, and get a look at how this one held up. Here is our style at the 4-hour mark in our day. We can see for the most part, it's totally fine. I do note some improved texture there as the day went on. We see this even more so here at the 8-hour mark, where things have lifted quite a bit, but we still have a good overall presence in the hair. I think using a pre-styler did help a little bit with the lightening up of the product. It made it go quite a bit longer throughout the day, but I did really enjoy just using it by itself too. I felt like using it by itself really gave you access to the full effect that it provides, that full volume and texture. Washing it out also really wasn't that big a deal for me. It is an oil-based clay, but it's petrol-free, so it doesn't take much to get it out at all. For me, it just took one round with a good heavy cleanser, and it was totally out of my hair. Now, the scent, I do have to say, was a bit strong for my sensitive nose. You know how I am with scents. I'm allergic to a lot of them, but I think I found it at times a bit too floral, but at the same time, the evergreen scent was kind of nice too. So for me, it just kind of goes both ways. I really dig the evergreen portion, but the floral portion kind of made me choke up a little bit, so take that for what you will. My final thoughts here on this clay is that it's definitely an awesome formula, and for me, a really cool first look into this brand. I know some of you might have some reservations over that $24 price tag, and in some cases, I do think going this high is not quite worth it, but here, I do think it's worth the price. At the amount that it should be used, I think it should take you quite a bit longer than usual to finish the jar. And for the quality ingredients that they use and source to make their products, this, to me, allows for somewhat of a price increase. Next, the hold. For me, I do think the medium hold in my hair was accurate, but I did notice the hold wasn't extremely present in the hair. The hold was there somewhat for me, definitely, but I don't think the product was designed to have the hold take over, because if it did, it would just restrict the hair from that volume and texture. It's definitely lightweight and doesn't weigh the hair down, which is nice. For those that have that super thick hair, though, I still think this could work for you as long as you don't fully rely on the hold itself. It does have that conditioning effect that I think would work with folks with thick hair. Thin hair, folks, I think you still have a shot with this one too. Just use little bits, and I think that should help you take advantage of the texture that this one has to offer. Lastly, the whole time I was testing this out, I kept thinking to myself that it really reminds me of American Gardens by Sheer Revival, which is also an oil-based clay. It even somewhat has a similar consistency to it coming out of the jar. Where the two differ for me, though, is I think Gardens has a bit more hold and is a tad more oily as the day goes on, where this one has a bit more dryness to it and a bit more texture and volume. As always, though, I encourage you guys to decide for yourself if it's worth it or not, and check it out if you decide to do so. If you would like to check it out, though, links will be in the description along with a coupon code from the fine folks at the Mailroom Barber for you guys, my subscribers, to save a little money. I do hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, let me know by hitting that thumbs up button there and dropping me a comment. I love hearing from you guys on these videos. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for me to the channel. That's a big deal. We have a big goal to try and hit this year. 25,000 subscribers. It's a big goal. I definitely think we can do it though, but I need your guys' help to make it happen. And that is it for today. I want to thank you so much for stopping by the channel today. I will be back with you guys again very soon. Take it easy. I'll see you next time.